I'm Michael Kirby, and in a sense, I'm an old piece of porcelain who's been brought along to this wonderful exhibition to perform the opening ceremony. Normally, this would be done on the occasion of the actual opening ceremony, but we shifted it because of the COVID-19 virus, and the COVID-19 virus shows many appearances in this exhibition in direct and indirect ways, and I'm very proud that I've been asked to help in the launch of this wonderful exhibition. This gallery is very well placed because the road outside leads directly to Botany Bay. Botany Bay was originally named by Captain Cook Botanist's Bay, and it was named after two botanists, Joseph Banks and Daniel Solander, who was a Swede. And those two gentlemen were the original scientists who recorded the still life of the Australian continent for the purpose of taking back images to London. And the still life plates, which were prepared by Joseph Banks and by Solander, were a sensation when they arrived in England. And the still images from a different continent, from a different world, were a way of conveying the beauty and variety and novelty of the Australian continent. So, from the very beginning, our country, following European settlement, was very much engaged with art and with representation of the things that were special and unique. And this exhibition is an exhibition that displays the work of two wonderful artists. Now, they have the misfortune of not having been born in Australia. Tena koutou, tena koutou, tena koutou katoa. And we Australians have to learn so many things from the New Zealanders, including respect for our Indigenous people. And I express my respect for them on this occasion, and their great civilization and culture is very important for all Australians. But Rex Turnbull and Ross Fairhurst have had interwoven careers, and Rex is the master and Ross is the pupil, and their work together comes in lovely combination in this exhibition. Now, Rex won his first exhibition prize back, I think it was in 1972, and it was a prize, an award, that was like the New Zealand equivalent of the Wynn Prize. And the Wynn Prize is a prize for works that display the beauty of nature. And that prize was judged by Sir William Dargie. Now, you don't hear much about Dargie nowadays, but he was a very great artist. And in fact, he won the Archibald Prize 8 times. And he picked out Rex's work as showing tremendous gifts. Dargie was a very great artist, so he was a person who knew what he was up to. And since then, Rex has had a marvellous career. He's exhibited in many famous exhibitions, not only in Australia and New Zealand, but also in Singapore, in the United Kingdom, in Germany, and elsewhere. He's been a finalist in the Wynn Prize I think it's three or maybe four times, and he's an artist of great accomplishment. The Law Society of New South Wales, made up of hard-nosed lawyers, chose one of his works, which is on display here, for the winning prize. He's a prize-winning artist. He has exhibited many times. He's been in charge of important galleries in the United Kingdom. But above all, he's a teacher, and he's a person who, by his own works and in company with pupils like Ross, he has developed a kind of school, and that school is represented in this exhibition. Now, Ross has also had a very interesting career, Ross Fairhurst. He was born, as every second New Zealander was, on a dairy farm. And he then went straight to the top. He got a job at Government House in Wellington, New Zealand. He wasn't going to mess around in other more humble places. And at that place, he was a footman, or probably a foot lad, because he was then a very young person. And his work at Government House got him involved in dressage, and he puts in his biodata something most people wouldn't mention, which was that he got the sack. And he got the sack for some, what he says, is a minor security breach. Her Majesty the Queen was about to turn up, so nothing was minor, but left Government House, turned his back on all the lords and ladies, and he turned to beauty and to art. And this exhibition displays his ongoing love of it under the tutelage of Rex's instruction. And those two, Rex and Ross, have come together in this exhibition, which is truly wonderful. Now, the first group of paintings which I saw on arriving here are those on my left, and they display wonderful presentations with absolute fine accuracy of works of art of porcelain, which have been brought to life by Ross, and which are displayed in beautiful, genuine, authentic colours, some of which he's tarted up a bit and tried to make a little bit more gripping. He has a great love of beauty, and it comes up in his works. My partner Johan and I have a lot of porcelain, and a lot of it is blue and white, which was the traditional understated Chinese decorative feature of porcelain. But Ross has found other works in the MacLeod collection, which he has reproduced in painted form, sometimes with uncanny accuracy of the original, sometimes brighter and more colourful than the original. But all of them are gems, small works of great beauty, and I'm sure that you will appreciate them as I have, as I've looked at them. Here is the beauty and magnificence of original Chinese decorative porcelain, and it's produced in painted form. Ross told me that originally most of the original works were actually hidden during the Cultural Revolution in China, hidden underground, and only later were they brought out into the open. And now, here in Australia through the magnificent artistic work under the instruction of Rex Turnbull, Ross Fairhurst has produced these wonderful reproductions. It's truly a mixture of Chinese original and brilliant artistic innovation from Ross, and I love them all. In fact, one of them I have in my collection, and I'm very proud that that is so. Now, the master is Rex Turnbull, and his works are on the right, as I look at them. These are greatly affected by the COVID-19 virus, and that has really been a shocking thing for us in Australia. For once, if I can say so, our politicians seem to have mostly done the right thing, and we've got out of the pandemic better than most countries, but it's still being a very frightening and worrying time. And in these very accurate presentations by Rex are images that we'll never forget what we've been through, what the world has been through, what our species has been through. The way in which he's reproduced the plastic which we have wrapped food so that it will get free of the droplets that bring the virus is brilliant. And the way he's reproduced plastic, I defy you to look at it and work out how an artist can put on painting the reproduction of plastic. Plastic isn't the most beautiful of the developments of human beings, but it's very much a feature of the COVID-19 virus protecting food from danger. And so these works are works similarly small in size, but so many of them so accurately reproducing images of a pandemic. In years to come, this collection, when it's reassembled and brought together, will remind people of the terrible time of the pandemic. The reproduction of the front page of the newspaper with the stories of the virus. This has been a grim time, but artists take their strength from their surrounding and their inspiration from emotions that people go through. Why do artists do it? It's actually a very interesting question. Gustav Mahler used to go up into the mountain. Most of the time he was conducting orchestras, but he'd go up in the mountain and he'd have to be all on his own when he would compose his music. And visual artists, Judy Kassab told me how she had to get something that got her going. She had to have a piece of cloth or something, a tie, that would get her started. And I was recently reading about Georges Simenon, who wrote the Maigret books. He would have an idea in his mind. He would have to sit down. He would have to do it. He'd have to write and compose it. And then when he finished, he would vomit. He'd got it out of himself. And so it's very interesting to see these works of visual artists. How important is the human spirit, and how important it is to bring these thoughts and ideas to life. And we are the beneficiaries. And so congratulating Rex Turnbull and Ross Fairhurst for this wonderful exhibition, congratulating them for sharing their artistic sense with us. I have much pleasure in declaring open this exhibition. It's a magnificent display of the human spirit, including the human spirit during a time of plague. And it's therefore one which will speak to all of us as we look at it. This exhibition is a celebration of the life of a fellow artist, Joan Swarbrick. She was a pupil of Rex and a fellow student and pupil with Ross. She died recently and she was greatly loved, and her spirit is alive in this exhibition too.